Est-ce que tout le monde est prêt?
I learned trombone when I was a kid. I was I played in the jazz band that was at school. I have always loved jazz music, and I try and incorporate into my music as much as I can. All the artists that I really love, the songwriting skills of and the production skills of, have always used jazz as an influence. So like Stevie Wonder for me is a huge, huge influence, and his influences are, you know, jazz music and soul music and old Motown songs and things like that. And you can find jazz littered everywhere inside of that. That and blues, those are my two big ones. My dad introduced me to guitarists and guitar-led music and lots of blues music when I was very, very little. And most importantly, introduced me to a man called Stevie Ray Vaughan, who's played the Monterey Jazz Festival, I think, twice when he was still with us. And I just learned everything that he did. I just tried to learn everything that he did. Bearing in mind, I was like 11 at this point, so could not play any of it because he's... You know, he was the greatest living blues guitarist. Well, yeah, so the first time I heard about the Montreux Jazz Festival was when I bought a DVD, it was three DVDs. It was a Stevie Ray Vaughan DVD. It was a live performance of his, I think it's his 1982, 1983 performance. And then a documentary about his life and the importance of the Montreux Jazz Festival. In the beginning of his career, and then his return to the Montreux Jazz Festival later in the 80s, which I think was in like 87 or 88 or something, I can't remember. But that was the first time I heard about it. And I remember listening or watching this documentary and saying, you know, Stevie Ray Vaughan, the incredible guitarist, gets invited to go and play at this prestigious jazz festival. And I'm like, well, I haven't got a clue what this is, so I bet it's amazing though. And he gets booed off stage. And I'm like, whoa, that's ridiculous. But in the audience was David Bowie and Jackson Browne. So already my head is like, I don't know what this festival is about, but it sounds amazing. And ever since then, I've heard about the people that have come to play it. I've heard about what people have said about it, and I've kind of come to understand more about its legacy and its importance to music, and especially currently, about the way that, that you guys have kind of started to catalog and document all of these performances and put them into this big, like, it's incredible what the Montreux Jazz Festival is about to do for music is incredible, like unbelievable, awe-inspiringly incredible. So it's going to be very exciting next year because it's 50th anniversary next year, isn't it? It's gonna be amazing. Yeah, so I'm now a big fan. I'm a big convert. Yeah, I love this place.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me. Thank
you. Been great.
No, thanks, man. Thank you.
Thank you. And for the bit, I had to ask you.
Of course, you got to. Yeah, no, I understand.
I heard that sound that I was looking for, which was a very warm.
Gehst im Gang entlang, gehst, nimmst den dritten, vierten.